Alam mo, Alice, mahirap tumakbong mayor. As a matter of fact, it is very difficult to win kung wala kang leaders, supporters na tutulong sa'yo. Since you've known John Feliciano since 2016, kung hindi ikaw ang tumulong sa kanyang politika, then who did? Sino ang tumulong kay John Feliciano? Gaano ka ba kalapit dito kay John Feliciano?
Magkaibigan po, Your Honor.
Kung papipiliin ko po kayo, Mayor, si Alice Goo po ba? Friend or acquaintance lang?
Friend.
So, and do you confirm that the land being occupied by Hong Sheng belongs to Alice Goo?
Yes, ma'am.
You confirm that?
Yes, ma'am. Because she was the one who requested the letter of intent to me para po ma-endorse ko po sa Sangguniang Bayan to get the letter of no objection.
The Bao Fu?
Yeah, no, yung Hong Sheng po, ma'am. Hong Sheng. Because she endorsed the letter of intent to me. So ako naman mo, on my part, as the local chief executive, bibigyan po ko ng sulat sa Sangguniang Bayan to act on that request.
Alice, I remember last time you denied this. You said you never represented Hong Sheng.
Ito ang latest update sa kaso ng mayor ng Bamban Tarlac na si Alice Goo ng di umano'y nasasangkot sa ilegal na aktibidad sa ating bansa. May nakitang sinyales ang mga kongresista kaugnay sa totoong pagkatao ni dating Bamban Tarlac Mayor Alice Goo. Kumbinsido si Batangas Congresswoman Attorney Jervil Jinky Luistro na tila naging sensitibo umano si Alice Goo tungkol sa paglantad at paglalahad ng tunay na pagkatao nito ni Chinese spy na si Xi Xijiang. Nakapagtataka umano na mula sa pagiging relax lamang na humarap sa mga pagdinig ay biglang nag-iba ang mukha at reaksyon ni Goo pagdating sa spy video. We touch something which is sensitive information on Alice Goo. So it's two things. It's either she was mad because she hates being charged or suspected as a spy, or she was mad because evidence corroborating claims that she is a Chinese spy, ani Attorney Jinky Luistro. Paulit-ulit namang itinanggi ni Goo na isa siyang espiya kasabay ng pagsasabing mahal niya ang Pilipinas at pinanindigang Pilipino siya. Sabi naman ni Attorney Luistro, "We will never know until we conduct a deeper investigation on Alice Goo being a Chinese spy." Matatandang si Davao Oriental Representative Gino Almario ang nagtanong sa report tungkol sa Chinese spy na si Xi Xijiang. Base sa Al Jazeera video documentary, sinabi ni Xi Xijiang na nagbigay umano siya ng pondo kay Goo Hwa-ping na pinaniniwalaan siyang tunay na pangalan ng dating alkalde para sa election campaign nito sa Tarlac. Makikita umano sa mukha ni Goo ang pagkairita at galit habang itinatanggi ang naturang report na taliwas sa ipinakita nitong pagiging relax at palangiti sa kanyang pagharap at pagsagot sa pagdinig ng Quad Committee. Samantala, sa galing ng pagtatanong ni Attorney Jervil Jinky Luistro, napaamin niya ang dating mayor ng Bamban Tarlac na si John Feliciano at inilaglag niya si Alice Goo aka Goo Hwa-ping. Ating panuorin ang buong video.
Mr. Chair, I wish to ask Alice Goo. Miss Alice, sino po ang sinundan yung mayor?
Former Mayor John Feliciano.
Come again?
Former Mayor John Feliciano.
Joe Feliciano?
John Feliciano.
John Feliciano. And how associated are you? Gaano ka ba kalapit dito kay John Feliciano?
Magkaibigan po, Your Honor. Nakilala ko po siya, I think, during his second term.
Second term? Can Apo. You cite the year?
Di po ako masyado sure na sa year, second term, kung di po ako nagkakamali.
Siya ba ay nakatapos ng tatlong termino?
Yes po, Your Honor.
In other words, if you're referring to the second term, you met John Feliciano sometime in 2016 to 2019.
In between po, Your Honor.
In between 2016 to 2019. Ang sabi mo kanina, kaibigan mo si John Feliciano. Can you please enlighten us? gaano kayo kalapit na magkaibigan?
Your Honor, magkaibigan, magkakilala kami, nagkakilala kami nung second term po niya na kumuha po ako sa kanya ng business permit para sa piggery. And then, last term po niya, I think pandemic time na rin po.
Did you help in the campaign of John Feliciano in 2016?
Hindi po.
Did you help John Feliciano in 2019?
Hindi din po, Your Honor.
In other words, since you met John Feliciano, wala kang naitulong sa kanya pagdating sa kanyang kampanya. Is that correct?
Financially, wala po.
What do you mean by financially? If not financially, then what else or how else will you help him politically?
Of course, Your Honor, yung mga ibang botante po namin sa farm, kinakampanya po namin, yung mga ganun lang po.
And how many voters do you have in your farm?
I have, during that time, ngayon po kasi wala na, totally wala na. During by that time po, siguro po more than 50 or more than 70 po.
Alam mo, Alice, mahirap tumakbong mayor. As a matter of fact, it is very difficult to win kung wala kang leaders, supporters, na tutulong sa'yo. Since you've known John Feliciano since 2016, kung hindi ikaw ang tumulong sa kanyang politika, then who did? Sino ang tumulong kay John Feliciano?
Your Honor, I think the former mayor is here po. Better siya po yung sumagot kasi hindi rin po ako yung tumulong po sa kanya.
May we ask John Feliciano, the former mayor?
Yan, dito kanina. Mayor Feliciano?
Can you please occupy one of the chairs?
Yes, Madam Chair.
Mr. Feliciano? Since based on the manifestation of Alice Goo, wala naman siyang naitulong siya sa'yo 2016 and 2019 na eleksyon. Sino ang mga taga-Banban na malaki ang naitulong sa'yo during those times of election?
Madam Chair, our town is small, 40,000 votes. During my term, bale, I introduced a lot of improvements in my town.
Mr. Chair, can we direct the resource speaker to please be responsive to the question? Ang tanong po, Mr. Feliciano, sino po ang tumulong sa inyong manalo 2016 and 2019 election?
Before you answer, Mayor, can we ask the committee secretary to administer the oath? Have you taken your oath?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sige. Please, I'm sorry. Please continue, Congresswoman Luistro.
Mr. Feliciano, did you get the question?
Yes, ma'am. Bali, on my town, ang tumulong po sa akin, yung mga kababayan ko po. So, yung mga kapitan, yung mga leaders ko, and yung mga family members ko po sa bayan namin.
How about your vice mayor? Did he help you?
Kasama din po sila. Si Vice Mayor William Cura po ang kasama ko. No?
Malaki ba ang naitulong sa ni Vice Mayor?
Physically po.
Physically. How about your council members? Did they help you?
Yes, ma'am. Actually, I'm proud to say, on my second term, isa lang po ang nalaglag sa mga councilors ko.
So, 7 of your 8 members.
Yes, Madam Chair.
Dedicated their support on your 2016 and 2019 election. How about the barangay captains? Ilan ho bang kapitan mayroon kayo?
Out of the 15 po, sa akin po lahat sila. And on my last term, wala po nalaglag sa ticket ko. 10-0 po kami lahat.
How many barangays do you have?
15 lang po.
1-5?
Yes, ma'am.
And the total of 15 barangays all supported you during your 2016 and 2019 election?
Yes, Madam Chair.
Kanina po sabi ni Alice Goo, wala siyang naitulong sa inyo 2016. Wala din siyang naitulong sa inyo 2019. Except yung botante na nagtatrabaho sa kanilang farm. Do you confirm that?
Yes, Madam Chair.
And aside from doon sa butanteng nagtratrabaho sa farm nila, mayroon ho ba kayong malalim na pinagsamahan ni Alice Goo? Like for example, nagka-problema ho ba kayo na ni-rescue niya kayo? Meron ho ba kayong mga ganyang pinagsamahan? Or nangutang ho ba kayo sa kanya at pinaluwag niya kayo?
Hindi naman po. During my time, because yun na po yung nagkaroon ng ASF, that's why most of the time po, pumunta po sila ng munisipyo kasama po yung hog raisers to address the problem. So, doon lang po kami naging close, Madam Chair. Because most of the time, papasyal po sila because na-wipe up nga po ang population ng hog and swine. So, that's the time we had ample of conversations, Madam Chair.
Kung papipiliin ko po kayo, Mayor, si Alice Goo po ba? Friend or acquaintance lang?
Friend.
Friend.
Yes, ma'am.
But you have several other friends who might be more attached to you than Alice Goo. Do you confirm that?
Ah, marami po, siyempre.
Marami.
Opo.
No? Ang gusto ko pong itanong, Mayor, considering na si Alice Goo, wala namang naitulong sa inyo 2016. Wala ding naitulong sa inyo 2019. And you even said that there are several other friends who are more attached to you than Alice Goo. Bakit po siya ang in-endorse niyong tumakbong mayor?
Madam Chair, during my time, dahil maliit lang nga po ang bayan namin, I believe a good businessman should be the one running the municipality or local chief executive.
Mayor, why do you say that Alice Goo is a good businessman?
Because from the time I knew her, 2016, siya na po ang sabihin na natin na responsible po doon sa mga piggery nila sa bayan ng Bamban. And it so happened, nakita ko naman na napalaki nila, and during the pandemic, nakita ko she was able to control the yung pagkamatay po ng mga baboy nila. So a good businesswoman, so sabi ko, why not try and ask her to if she wanted to run.
You manifest that you are the one who offered that opportunity to her?
Yes, Madam Chair, because...
Kayo po ang nag-alok, hindi niya hiniling.
Hindi po, kasi po during that time, I had a falling out with my fellow, yung kaibigan ko nga, because I ran for Congress. So it so happened, we had a falling out with my barangay captain. So sabi niya, hindi ka pwedeng tumakbo, kailangan ako lang. I needed someone on my back. Ay mahirap pong tumakbo ng Congress kung wala ka pong mayor sa bayan mo. So, sad to say, ang option ko na lang was to ask her if she wanted. And then she said, sige, give me 30 to 60 days and I'll decide. And then after pungunon, Madam Chair, after 60 days, so let's try it out. Let's ask her, yung mga kababayan natin, kung papayagan tayo. And then, everything fall through.
How about your vice mayor?
Ang vice mayor ko po, ang nangyari noon, nagpunta rin po rin sa kabila.
How about your council members?
Naiwan po sa akin lahat yung pito.
And you did not consider any of them?
Wala po, ma'am eh, kasi hindi
to succeed
po,
to your mayoralty?
Wala pong capable. They're not capable of...
Aside from the piggery business mayor, what consideration did you consider? What factor did you consider why you offered the mayoralty to Alice Goo?
Wala naman po. Nothing came into me. Ganun lang po, kasimple naman yun eh.
Just offered the position to Alice Goo?
Yes, ma'am. Kasi during that time, it was already close. Wala na akong magawa, ma'am, because...
How close, Mayor?
No, the time frame during that time that my friend told me not to run, and we were already having a squabble kung sinong gagamitin ko as my candidate. Ma'am, masyado na maigsi yung oras. So wala nang panahon, ma'am.
I understand, Mayor, during your time, may Hongsheng na.
Yes, ma'am. Meron
so,
na,
do you confirm na kayo po ang unang nag-issue ng business permit sa Hongsheng?
Yes, ma'am. I was the one.
And how do you describe the operation of Hongsheng?
Actually, ma'am, nung sa Hongsheng, hindi naman ako, ma'am, nakapasok doon because it was a regulated Philippine offshore gaming operator. And so, I believe Banban wasn't the one having the Philippine offshore gaming operations. Ma'am, during that time, nag-review din ako, nag-study rin ako. Almost 400 po nag-ooperate as far as Cavite, may Cagayan, meron pong Cagayan Valley.
Oh, let's concentrate to Hong Sheng, Mayor.
Ayun nga, ma'am.
So, and do you confirm that the land being occupied by Hong Sheng belongs to Alice Goo?
Yes, ma'am.
You confirm that?
Yes, ma'am, because she was the one who requested the letter of intent to me para po ma-endorse ko po sa Sangguniang Bayan to get the letter of no objection.
The Bao Fu?
Yeah, no, yung Hong Sheng po, ma'am, Hong Sheng.
You are stating now, Mayor, that you were the one who endorsed the letter of Alice Goo to Hong Sheng to be able to secure a letter or resolution of no objection. Yeah, because, that's what you said.
Yes, ma'am, because she endorsed the letter of intent to me. So ako naman on my part as the local chief executive, bibigay po ako ng sulat sa Sangguniang Bayan to act on that request.
Alice, I remember last time you denied this. You said you never represented Hong Sheng.
Your Honor, I translate for Hong Sheng, and for Hong Sheng po, I invoke my right against self-incrimination for the cases filed at the court po.
But I wish to manifest, Mr. Chair, that in tonight's hearing, contrary to the representation of Alice Goo, Mayor Feliciano is now saying that it was Alice Goo who approached him and facilitated the resolution interposing no objection to the establishment of Hong Sheng, in which SEC documents the name of Alice Goo appears as representative, which fact Alice Goo likewise denied during the last hearing. Mayor Feliciano?
Yes, Madam Chair.
During your congressional bid, simultaneous with the mayoralty of Alice Goo?
Yes, Madam Chair.
Ano pong itinulong sa inyo ni Alice Goo?
Yung pong makapagsalita po ako sa entablado niya, malaking bagay na po sa akin yon.
Sabi niyo po, magaling na businesswoman si Alice Goo.
Yes, Madam Chair.
So what support did she extend to you during your congressional bid?
Sa bayan lang po ng Bamban, yung maisama ka na dun sa grupo niya na hindi ka na maglalagay ng entablado, tapos yung pagbayad po sa mga watchers, so hindi na po niya ako hinasel. So that is fine, and tama na po para sa akin yon.
So there are no campaign funds that were extended to you?
Wala po, kaya po natalo ko. Yun lang pong sa akin.
How many towns do you have in your district?
Madam Chair, we have 4.
4 towns?
Yes, Madam Chair.
And ang naitulong lang ni Alice Goo is the audience.
Yes, Madam Chair.
During the campaign period, tama ba?
Yes, Madam Chair.
Is that the only thing that you're expecting from the businesswoman whom you describe as a very good businesswoman?
On my part po kasi, Madam Chair, what I learned was when you try to run for office, kung may magbibigay ng tulong, salamat. Kung wala, salamat din para at least wala pong magsisisihan sa bandang uli.
I'd like to go back to Hong Sheng, Mayor.
Yes, Madam Chair.
Mayor, do you understand that this Hong Sheng was later on found out to be a POGO operation?
Madam Chair, yung pong letter of no objection was part of a PAGCOR license given by our gaming industry. So alam ko po na ganun talaga siya. And I believe Philippine offshore gaming operators are legally in a sense.
Can you describe to us how many buildings are erected in Hong Sheng?
I'm not really sure kung ilan po eh. Yung
approximate?
5 or 6.
And do you recall kung magkano ang real property tax na ibinabayad sa inyo during that time?
Ngayon po, more than 15 million po.
During your time, Mayor?
Yes, that was ngayon pong pagbaba ko po.
More than 15
yes,
million?
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
And where were you nung na-convert ito as Yunzuan Corporation?
Ah, wala na po.
Was
ako
it
noon.
During your term?
No, hindi na po. Because later part na po kasi yun noong 2022 eh. And then, baba na po ako noon.
How about the Baofu land, Mayor? When Alice Goh acquired this land, what is the classification of this land?
This land was agricultural and then she requested for a reclassification way back 2019.
So it was during your time when the land was reclassified?
Yes, Madam Chair.
It was reclassified from agricultural to industrial. Do you confirm that?
Residential and commercial, Madam Chair.
From residential to commercial?
No, agricultural, residential / commercial.
From agricultural to residential, commercial. And
yes,
for your recollection, do you believe that the requirements for reclassification were duly complied with?
Yes, Madam Chair, I believe so.
Yes, and with respect to Hongsheng, Mayor, the entire process of this resolution or letter interposing no objection, it was Alice Goh who was representing Hongsheng. Do you confirm that?
Yes, Madam Chair, because her name was written also on the Sangguniang Resolution.
And aside from the name being written in the Sangguniang Bayan Resolution, it was Alice Goh, or likewise, who is lobbying with the Sangguniang Bayan, and even in your office, do you confirm that?
Actually po, hindi naman nag-lobby. She just submitted the letter of intent.
How many times did she visit your office to represent Hongsheng?
Twice.
If you are aware, how many times did he visit the Sangguniang Bayan for the purpose of that no objection for Hongsheng?
Once.
I wish to manifest, Mr. Chair, that contrary to the statement of Alice Goh, that she never represented Hongsheng during its application for permit and even in the issuance of letter or resolution of no objection, John Feliciano is now testifying that it was Alice Goh who represented and facilitated the no objection resolution for Hongsheng, the POGO operation. I submit, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Congresswoman Luis Tro.
During the previous hearing, even in the Senate, inamin mo po yung tatay mo is a Chinese, di ba?
Yes po, Your Honor.
And what is the name of your father?
Goh Jianzhong.
Goh Jianzhong. Okay. How about yung Len Wen Lee?
She's the partner of my dad.
The partner of your dad. Kaya sa korporasyon niyo, nandun yung pangalan niya. Then yung mga kapatid mo. Tama po?
Opo, Your Honor.
Okay. So, Chinese din siya?
Lin Wen Lee is a Chinese po.
Okay. When was the last time na nagkita kayo ni Lin Wen Lee?
April this year or May?
April or May this year. Saan po?
Kung hindi po ako nagkakamali, sa Marilao.
Marilao, Bulacan?
Yes po, Your Honor.
Bakit, may property ba siya dyan? May business niya o ano?
Andun po yung embroidery business po.
Niya?
For the family po.
Ah, yung family. Okay. Okay, anyway. When was the first time that you acquire a Filipino passport? The first time?
Your Honor, hindi ko po malala ngayon. I just have to check yung first passport ko po. Pero sa ngayon po, hindi ko po malala nung year po.
Hindi mo malala yung year?
I think I have four Filipino passport na nakapag-renew ng three or four times. Pero I just
three
have to check
times.
Po.
BID, do you have a record? Narito ba yung DFA? DFA? Please, okay, pwede si BID. When was the Alice Goh acquire her Filipino passport?
It's not exactly she acquired it, Your Honor. Our record is when she first used it. So she first used her Philippine passport on April 22, 2008. The number of the Philippine passport is RR 040-1472.
So,
that's a departure, Your Honor.
So, 2008?
Yes, Your Honor.
So, this is the first departure?
That was under this particular name, under the name Alice Go, or Your Honor.
Yeah, Alice Go. Okay. DFA. DFA. Do you have a records with regards to the first issuance of passport for Ms. Alice Go?
Good evening, Honorable Chair. Unfortunately, we could not retrieve the date when the first passport was issued. It was no longer in our records.
Grabe naman kayo. BID nga may record ng first travel niya, tapos kayo DFA, wala kayong record?
We do have the passports issued after that, sir.
Yung renewal?
Yes, sir.
When was that?
There were renewals in 2011, 2015, and 2020, sir.
2011,
2015, and 2020, sir.
Okay. So, in short, before 2008, April, may passport na siya because that was the first travel of Miss Alice Go.
Yes, sir. I also confirmed the issuance of the passport number that was earlier stated from the BI.
Miss Alice Go, how old are you now?
38 years old po.
38. Okay. BID, when was the first entry of a certain Go Waping in the country? Is it the January ata 2003? Tama ba?
The first entry of Gua Waping with birthday August 31, 1990 and Chinese passport number 567-9410 was on January 12, 2003, Your Honor.
So, January 12, 2003.
Yes, Your Honor.
Yung date of birth niya?
The date of birth of the Gua Waping in this particular case, Your Honor, is 31 August 1990. Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. Anyway, when was the... May travel record ba kayo ng Gua Waping since 2003?
Yes, Your Honor.
So, yung first, di ba pumasok siya in the Philippines?
Yes, Your Honor.
As what? Visit?
The first tourist entry of the Gua Waping was, as I've said, in January 12, 2003, Your Honor.
Ano bang tourist?
Yes, Your Honor.
Then the next?
Actually, it isn't indicated here, Your Honor.
Anyway, from the Philippines, yung first na paglabas niya?
She left the country on her first departure as Gua Waping was on December 21, 2006, Your Honor.
2006. So, Gua Waping stays in the country for 3 years.
Yes,
tama?
Your Honor. Yes, Your Honor.
Anong visa niya o passport niya?
Apparently, Your Honor, during that period, she was able to get an SIRV, a special investor's visa, the one issued by the Board of Investments of the Department of Trade and Industry.
Okay. So, 2006 siya lumabas ng bansa. Kailan siya bumalik?
She returned on January 19, 2007, and during this particular time, her status was that of an SIRV, Your Honor.
So, 2007?
Yes, Your Honor.
Less than a year, bumalik siya?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, ang next na travel ni Goa Ping, palabas ng bansa?
So, after that arrival on January 19, Mr. Chair, she again left on January 4, 2008.
2008, left the country?
That is correct, sir.
Okay. Then, entry?
Entry is January
28, 2008. Sandali. Ang paglabas niya is 2008, di ba?
Yes, sir. January 24, 2008. And then, she arrived on January 29, 2008, Your Honor.
So, few days lang?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. So, same 2008 ang pagbalik?
Yes, Your Honor.
Pabalik-balik lang si Goa Ping, no? After that, may travel pa ba palabas?
Yes, Your Honor. The next departure was on May 15, 2008. And she returned on May 17, 2008.
So, mas matagal siya dito kaysa travel niya palabas. Bumabalik agad.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, ang pinakalas na travel ni Goa Ping, para mabilis na lang po.
The last travel of Ho Goa Ping she used passport number G3374414418 was on March 22, 2011, Mr. Chair. Yes, Your Honor.
Okay.
That's during her arrival in the country.
DFA, when was the renewal of Miss Alice Goa dun po sa 2011? Yung first renewal. Huwag ka muna umalis, DFA. Umupo ka nga para mabilis tayo. Specific date and month, 2011.
It was renewed on the 7th of March, sir, 2011.
2nd of March.
The 7th, sir. March 7, 2011.
March 7.
Po.
So, 2011, March renewal.
Yes, sir.
March of also 2011, that was the last time that Alice Goa Ping enters the country. Tama?
Yes, Your Honor.
Anong date?
March 22, 2011.
So, March 22, a matter of 15 days. After that, wala na pong travel record.
After that, Your Honor, we don't have any more travel of record of
Goa. So, hindi na nakalabas ng bansa si Goa Ping?
Yes, Your Honor.
So, baka sumakay sa yate?
That would be possible, Your Honor.
Miss Alice Go. Oh, 15 days. Nirenew mo yung passport mo, Filipino passport. Then, March 15, that was the last travel record of Goa Ping. And after that, hindi na po siya lumabas, hindi na nakita, may Alice Goa na passport. What can you say about it?
For that allegation po, Your Honor, I refuse
to answer. That is not allegation. That is the facts. I am not accusing you. I am just saying that Alice Goa renewed his passport March 7. And Goa Ping last travel was also 2011 of March. Biglang nawala. Biglang naglaho. Hindi na nakabalik. When was the last time? Anong country po? Country of origin ni Goa Ping?
Wait, Your Honor. It wasn't indicated here, Your Honor. During her last trip in 2011, the destination was not indicated here, which is just normal during that time, Your Honor, because the ports were not encoded during that time.
But of course, DFA, siguro may record kayo. Tama? Kasi tinatatakan yun, di ba? DFA.
The records outside, sir?
Yeah. Di ba, paglabas mo dito sa bank, sa pagpasok mo doon sa country of entry, may tatak, di ba? Paglabas mo doon, may tatak din. Pagpasok mo dito, tatakan din, di ba?
Oh, we defer to the BI, sir.
Hindi, yung passport. Kasi wala nga silang record, di ba? Tama?
Yes, sir, but if they renew the passport, they keep the passport kasi, so we don't have...
Hindi, pero yung records nyo, wala?
Wala po, sir.
Bakit?
We don't keep the records yun ang problema, of the outside travel, sir.
That's why yung passport law, dapat ayusin natin yun. We have to amend that. Kasi hindi natin matrace. Kasi, tingnan mo, OBID, yung frequent travel ni Goa Ping, anong country?
During that time, Your Honor, the destination wasn't indicated yet. So the only way we will find out if the passport is presented and then the departure stamp of that country can be
correct.
Determined.
So problema natin ngayon yan, DFA, kasi wala kayong record. Tama?
Yes, sir, we don't because they keep the passport. The applicants keep the passport once they renew the
anyway, passport. Mr. Chevan, that's why kailangan po talaga na i-amend natin yung passport law. Ngayon, nakita na natin, may problema tayo. Diba? Tracing the passport of Miss Alice Goo and Miss Goa Ping. Now, Miss Goa Ping o Alice Goo, aka Alice Goo. During the investigation sa Senate, saka dito, diba, yung travel mo from the Philippines, as makay kayo sa yate, as also told by your sister, di ba ang entry niyo is Malaysia, tama?
Yes po, Your Honor.
Then, nag-Indonesia kayo, Singapore.
Opo, Your Honor. Your Honor, regarding po doon, I have immigration cases na rin po.
Hindi, tinatanong lang kita.
Opo.
What, that is not incriminating. What is incriminating na sinabi mo na yan doon? Sa hearing, nire-review ko lang. Di ba? On record na yan. Di ba naka-record na yan? Tama?
Opo, Your Honor.
Okay. Now, why Miss Alice Go? Inamin mo tatay mo, Inchik. Bakit hindi ka, instead of going to Malaysia, backdoor, then nag-Indonesia, Singapore, blah, blah, blah. Bakit hindi ka umuwi sa tatay mo sa China?
Your Honor, for that question po, may security concern po na related. I refuse to answer po.
Ayan ka na naman, security related. Tatay mo yung pupuntahan mo, security related. Ganon?
Your Honor, hindi po yung tatay ko ang...
Hindi, ang question ko, why hindi ka bumalik sa tatay mo? Di ba, instead of going to Malaysia, Indonesia, alam mo naman may kaso ka dito, naharapin. Di ba? Bakit hindi ka umuwi sa China and seek refuge to your father?
Your Honor, may related po na security concern.
Ano yun ang related security? Miss Alice Go. Ano yun?
Yung tao po nagpaalis po sa akin, Your Honor.
Ayan na naman tayo. Yung taong nagpaalis sa iyo, Inchik?
Yes, Chinese? Po, Your Honor.
So, mas malakas ba yung taong yun kisa sa tatay mo?
For the security concern po, Your Honor, I refuse to answer po.
Oh, you refuse to answer because you have already cited in contempt in this committee. Hindi mo na invoke yung ano, yung self-incriminating kasi hindi naman incriminating yun eh. Di ba? Tama. Mr. Chairman, ganito lang po. I do believe that even the security sector, especially the government agency involved in internal security, naintindihan po natin why Miss Alice Go or Go Wapping, instead of going to China and seek refuge to his father, hindi siya umuwi doon kasi alam na po natin, alam ng mga security sector, nasa security sector natin, na yun yung orientation. Sorry po, yun po, never go back to your country if your country will be incriminated in the cases that being filed to you in other countries. That's spying po, that is spionage. That's the dictum of being a spy. Hindi ka pwedeng umuwi sa bansa mo if your country masunog po doon sa mga pinagagawa mo doon po sa isang bansa outside of your country. Of course, Miss Alice Go, Go Wapping will not admit. Pero, sinasabi ko nga, eh yun yung orientation. Tingnan mo si Xie. Why? Ayaw niya pa-deport. Kasi, pag pina-deport siya, alam niya ang mangyayari sa kanya doon. Diba, Miss Alice Go?
Your Honor, hindi pa ako agree.
Sorry?
Your Honor, I don't agree po.
You don't agree?
Opo, in the first place po, Your Honor.
No, I'm not saying you don't agree with my jury. I'm not referring to you. Napaka-defensive mo. Ang sinasabi ko lang po, yung dictum doon ba sa mga spy at in relation to spionage, yun po ang orientation ng mga spy. I'm telling you that you're a spy. Ang sinasabi ko lang po, based on the records and everything, why instead of going and seek refuge to China, in which that is the mother country of your father, hindi ka pumunta at tumuwi doon dahil po, yun po. Just like what happened with Mr. Xi and all other spy in the whole world na nasunog kaysa masunog yung bansa nila, mas mabuti pang masunog na lang sila and they will face consequences in that foreign country. For now, Mr. Chairman, I end my interpellation. Thank you po.
Thank you, Congressman Paduano. Just for a short manifestation and emphasis on the short, Congresswoman Swan Singh, you are recognized.
With your permission, Mr. Chair, my slides and my manifestation is very much related to the interpellation of the Honorable Paduano. So maganda po siya na follow-up doon po sa interpellation ni Kong Paduano.
Okay, sige. Okay na? Okay, sige. Please proceed.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, I just wanted to put together a few of the documents that were previously presented in this committee as well as in the Senate hearings with regard to the identity of a certain Go Wapping. So, Mr. Chair, here in the first slide, this was sourced from the Bureau of Immigration. This is the list of travel records for Go Wapping. And here on this slide, I wanted to highlight here the date of birth that's indicated on the list of travel records, which is the date of birth repeatedly mentioned in this hearing, which is August 31, 1990. Mr. Chair, I would like to quickly pause and ask Ms. Alice Go, do you still categorically deny that you are the Go Wapping in question with this particular information?
Your Honor, regarding citizenship, I invoke my right against self-incrimination because of the cases filed against me in the courts.
Mr. Chair, with that response, as you can see here, the status as highlighted by Representative Paduano is under the SIRV, so which is the Special Investor Residence Visa. So on the next slide, we see the SIRV of the said personality Go Hua Ping, and these were the documents presented by Senator Win Gachalian during the Senate hearing last June. And here we would highlight as well that this person has the same date of birth, which is August 31, 1990. So it appears based on the documents of the Bureau of Immigration and the Board of Investments that the Go Hua Ping in question is the same person. And as we can see here, the ID picture resembles very much the Miss Alice Go that is in front of us, Mr. Chair. So again, Mr. Chair, let me pause and ask, Miss Alice Go, do you still deny that you are the Go Hua Ping featured in this photo?
Your Honor, regarding the citizenship po, I invoke my right against self-incrimination po.
With that, Mr. Chair, I will move to my next slide. This, Mr. Chair, was the dossier that was previously presented by Representative Chino Almario in the Al Jazeera documentary. And in this dossier, Mr. Chair, this is allegedly the dossier for this Go Hua Ping. So we have here a Chinese translator, Mr. Chair. If I may, Ms. Batay, may I request you to please translate this date or these numbers that's featured inside the box.
Okay, so what's inside the box? First, on the first two words, that means 性别, or the gender, and the next word is 女, or girl, and then the next set of words, four words, 民族, that means racial ancestry. So it says here that it's 汉族, or the Han group of people, or it's the typical term for the Chinese in China. And the next level or the next line, it's 出生日期 or the birth date. Okay, the birth date is 1990, 8月, August 31. Yeah, 8月31.
Thank you very much, Ms. Batay. Given that I don't speak Chinese, Mr. Chair, I relied on Google Lens to translate this page for me. So on this next slide, just to verify and validate what Ms. Batay mentioned, ComSec, please show the next slide. So here, translated by Google Lens, very much verifies the translation shared by Ms. Batay. And here we can see that the date of birth of the Go Hua Ping featured in the documentary, who is allegedly a Chinese spy, also matches that of the Go Hua Ping on record in our Bureau of Immigration Documents and Board of Investment. So, Mr. Chair, kanina po, nung tinanong po ni Congressman Almario, si Ms. Alice Go, kung siya po ba yung tao na nandoon sa dossier na sinasabi na Chinese spy, sinabi niya po na hindi. So, Mr. Chair, again, for the third time in my interpellation, I will go back to Ms. Alice Go and again ask, Ms. Alice Go, are you the woman in this photo?
Hindi po, Your Honor.
Mr. Chair, yun lang po. Three times during my interpellation, Mr. Chair, tatlong beses po na sinabi ni Ms. Alice Go, itinanggi niya na siya po ang babae na nasa litrato, pero nakita naman po natin na yung babae po na nandun sa aking pangalawang slide na nasa ID picture na SIRV ay napakalapit po sa itsura ng babae na nasa litrato po doon sa dossier na sinasabi na Chinese spy. At napakalapit din po sa lahat po ng mga nadidito ngayong gabi. Nakikita naman po natin na ang Miss Alice Go na nasa harapan natin ay kamukhang kamukha po yung nasa dalawang litrato na ating pong ipresinta. So, Mr. Chair, yun lang po. I just wanted to add a little bit more beef doon po sa ating pong assertion na mukha pong yung babae po na tinutukoy doon po sa dokumentaryo na
Chinese spy po ay pareho doon po sa Gohuaping na kine-question po natin sa ating mga nakadaang pagtalakay. Maraming salamat po, Mr. Chair.
Thank you. We were presented by the Matrix when we started the hearing on Pogo. And indeed, Mr. Chair, the number of corporations, including the incorporators, are really overwhelming. However, Mr. Chair, I wish to commend DSJJ Suarez and SDS Dong Gonzalez for painstakingly presenting how Michael Young and Alan Lim are connected to all of this. However, Mr. Chair, to give us a rundown on how this investigation is going in relation to the matrix that was presented earlier, I wish to summarize what we have gone through already by enumerating the four significant personalities along with the corresponding location and the companies involved. So far, Mr. Chair, we were able to unfold the personality of Mayor Alice Goo, whom we later on found out is a Chinese national by the person Gohuaping. She is from Tarlac, where we found a compound we call Bao Fu, and where we see two corporations involved in Pogo, started with Hongsheng and later on converted to Yunzuan. The second personality, Mr. Chair, is Cassandra Lee Ong. She figured in Porac, Pampanga, where there is a location we call Whirlwind, catering to the Pogo operation of the company we call Lucky South. Tonight, Mr. Chair, we are all witnesses of the unfolding of another Chinese personality. This is in the person of Tony Young, the elder brother of Michael Young and Hong Jai Young. This time, Mr. Chair, the location is Cagayan de Oro, where there is such a compound we call Alwana Compound, and allegedly there are two companies involved in Pogo operation. One is Oro One and the other is Sanja Steel. Ultimately, Mr. Chair, what surprises us tonight is the seeming link of Miss Alice Goo, one of the Chinese Pogo operator, with a self-confessed Chinese spy by the name She Yang Zheng. Apparently, Mr. Chair, based on the documentary that was presented, he operated a Pogo corporation also. This one is in Myanmar, near the boundary of Thailand. And the name of the corporation is Yatai International Group, Mr. Chair. At this point, Mr. Chair, being the lead agency in this investigation, I wish to request the PAOK from their perspective, how do we connect these four already significant Chinese personalities figuring in our Pogo investigation, Mr. Chair? May we request Director Casio?
Madam Chair, as previously explained in the different hearings, it's more of the financial transactions that basically exposed the intricate links of these four said individuals and the companies to which they are also associated. So, but then again, Madam Chair, this is still an ongoing investigation, so we may still be able to uncover as we proceed with the financial investigation, as we defer to the AMLC, Madam Chair.
May we know, Mr. Chair, if PAOK has come across already this Oro One and Zanja Steel with respect to the allegation concerning POGO operation?
With regards to Oro One, Madam Chair, we heard about it during the because of a news report that was wherein a supposed inspection was conducted in the said location of Oro One. And then when we heard of that particular inspection, ma'am, we dug into our files and were able to check that indeed Oro One was a customer service representative of Shunwei Technology. By the way, Madam Chair, there are eight others at one time that were CSR of Shunwei Technology.
How about Sanjay Steel Corporation, Mr. Chair?
Madam Chair, with regards to Sanja, this is an ongoing investigation together with other law enforcement agencies and intelligence agencies, so to speak. We've seen the name of Philippine Sanja Steel in different alleged illegal transactions, not necessarily related to POGO, Madam Chair.
But have we visited the location of this Sanja Steel, the facility?
As far as the commission is concerned, Madam Chair, no. When the Bureau of Immigration was able to apprehend Mr. Yang last week at the National Ninoy Aquino International Airport, we've received reports that a good number of vans left the compound early morning of the same day, the following day that he was apprehended, supposedly with the purpose of bringing out the foreign nationals in the area.
I understand that the only case that Tony Yang is facing right now is violation of immigration law. Is this correct?
That is affirmative, Madam Chair.
Do we have AMLA here? Mr. Chair, I wish to ask the AMLA if he's seeing any case which can possibly be filed against Tony Yang concerning his several corporations here in the Philippines, particularly with respect to violation of the AMLA.
Magandang hapon po, Madam Chair. Madam Chair,
may we request the resource speaker to please speak louder and maybe closer to the microphone?
Magandang hapon po, Madam Chair. Money laundering is a derivative crime, meaning it has to proceed from an unlawful activity. As mentioned by Dr. Casio, what Mr. Yang is facing right now is violation of immigration law, which is not a predicate offense under the AMLA. But just the same, Your Honor, we are gathering all information, personalities that come up during investigation. We gather intelligence information and we investigate, Your Honor.
Mr. Chair, I wish to direct my question this time to Alice Goo. Mr. Chair, I wish to manifest likewise and direct this manifestation to AMLA, that I understand that there are cases already filed against the incorporators of Brick Hearts. Brick Hearts, which I understand is a subsidiary of Shunwei. And Shunwei being the company which is being served or serving Oro One and Sanja Steel. Considering the corporate relationship of Brick Hearts
Sean Way, Orwan, and Sanja Steele. Are we not considering any possibility of violation of AMLA? Having the cases filed already involving Brick Hearts as the predicate crime.
Your Honor, since the name of that corporation came up during the investigation of this committee and in news accounts, Your Honor, we have started our investigation on Brick Hearts, Your Honor.
May we ask PAOK, considering the presentation of DS J.J. Suarez earlier, that there was a kidnapping discovered in Brick Hearts, meron po ba tayong naka-file na kaso against the incorporators of Brick Hearts?
None to our knowledge, Madam Chair. We've heard of the kidnapping in relation to Shuangma Technology and in relation to Brick Hearts. But then again, I would direct the said question to the Philippine National Police because the said reports were directed to them during that time of the investigation, Madam Chair, not to the Commission.
Mr. Chair, can we hear from the PNP? If we have the PNP here. There is a kidnapping incident in Brick Hearts. This one involves a Filipina. So may we know if a case was filed concerning this kidnapping incident? Mr. Chair, this is the corporation layering that we have been explaining since day one of our investigation. As a matter of fact, even prior to the creation of Quadcom, we have observed already the creation of so many corporations, however, with interlocking directors that adds to challenges on the part of the government, including the agencies, the PAOK, the PNP, and the AMLA, in identifying the Chinese personalities to be held responsible by the various illegal activities hiding under the guise of POGO establishment or even a service, a customer service provider. Do we have PNP here?
Yes, Madam Chair, from the IDM, Colonel Landicho, ma'am.
Our question to PNP is whether a case was filed concerning the kidnapping incident involving Brick Hearts.
We will check on that, ma'am.
I hope that the PAOK will be coordinating closely with AMLA and with the PNP because I understand that this is a very complex illegal activity involving so many companies, so many corporations, so many foreign nationals that gives challenges to us on identifying who is he and who needs to be charged in court.
Madam Chair, rest assured I will bring this matter to our Undersecretary and to our Chairman, and we would do our best to coordinate with the said agencies in relation to Brick Hearts and Shuangma, because Brick Hearts has figured in so many POGO investigations already, Madam Chair.
I lament, Mr. Chair, that while we have unfolded already the personality of Cassie Ong, of Alice Goo, of Tony Young, and even she in the documentary, I understand that there are still several corporations hiding under the guise of being a Filipino corporation, also hiding under the guise of being a BPO or customer service provider. I hope we can look into all of this, especially those companies which were mentioned in the matrix at the early part of our hearing, Mr. Chair.
Mag-subscribe at i-click ang notification bell para sa mga susunod na video updates. Maraming salamat po.